Open my lips, O Lord, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence. Take not your Holy Spirit from me. Give me the joy of your saving help. Sustain me with your bountiful spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. This spring, I was lying in bed in my house in Ulster County, looking out the window in the morning, and for one of the first times in my life that I can ever recall, I didn't know what to do, get up or stay in bed. I didn't want to read, I didn't want to clean, I didn't want to rake the yard or work in the garden. I felt lost, and it lasted for some time. I didn't really know what it was, but I think it actually might have been a slight form of depression, which any time ever anything happened before, I never considered myself depressed at all. But I guess when you feel lost, that's one of the feelings. And I don't really know exactly what the connection was, but I realized that I needed to share my incredible fortune of still being on the planet with the people around me. I wanted to transmit the knowledge that I had, the joy that I had, that even with my sight nearly gone, I still felt like a very lucky person. And just that simply, the shroud kind of lifted, and I decided that I was going to create a school. So, being myself, I immediately called in bulldozers and wrecking balls and started pacing around the property. And there was that, in the spring, 50-foot-long chicken coop that had already nature had started to demolish on its own. But I had a great time watching the building be demolished and then burned to bits, and I just stood and watched it, and I thought, there goes my old TV show up in flames. Here comes the new part of my life. And I started to think parenthetically about turning 50 on June 2nd, 2010, and that from 50 to 60, the essence of what I would convey to people would be what I had been given, like a gift that I still don't really understand. And that is the joy to exist in a way that most people would think of as tragic. But I still feel like the Cheshire Cat. And, you know, the school is 50 feet long to go with my 50th year. It's called the John Dugdale School of 19th Century Photography and Aesthetics, which all my friends thought I was crazy and insisted that I shorten. But I spoke to my friend Paul Bellman, and when I told him the title and I was thinking of changing, he said, John, don't you dare change that title, not a word of it. And he pushed me out the door, and I thought, okay, I have deep respect for this man. And we leveled the ground, big bulldozers came, I poured 9,800 pounds of gravel and started writing the mission statement and just deciding what the classes were going to be. And I guess the most deeply important thing to me is that it's the word aesthetics. My friends kept saying in a well-meaning way, can't you do without the word aesthetics? And I said, no, I can't, because really the aesthetics of expressing yourself and the extreme beauty of the objects that I surround myself with, that people seem to respond to, simple things like silver and glass, flowers that I grow, china, even a piece of fabric, people come and say, oh, I wish I could live the way you do. And I always told them that they can. Why don't they? It's not a secret to have a life that's aesthetically pleasing. You don't have to be a special person, but you do have to have your eyes open sometimes. One of the ways that I'd like to mesmerize the school into being is by selling prints to people. One print would be for one window. Another print would be for a bundle of shingles. Another print would be for a doorway. You could even have your name on a doorknob, and that way I can include people in the spirit of the building they can be honorary trustees, but just give people the opportunity to be a part of this project. And hopefully that it's giving me such joy just looking forward to it, going out and pacing the circumference of the school. If I can include other people in it and take them on their journey, and they can help me by buying a couple of sideboards or a lintel or stone or some bricks for the school, I have this intuition that people are going to want to participate with me.